You've probably seen those showcase videos raving about China's epic high-speed railways, but then you spot those reddish-brown, rusty tracks and think, wait, are they skimping on maintenance? Shouldn't high-tech rails be shiny and spotless? Is it even safe? Well, buckle up, because that rust isn't a flaw. It's a deliberate, high-tech shield that makes the rails tougher, longer-lasting, and self-healing. Especially in China's vast network, where these tracks handle insane speeds and loads. So today, let's uncover the science behind it and see how a bit of rust can actually be a genius metallurgical design. Let's start with the basics. Railways don't just slap down random metal bars and hope for the best. Every track is carefully engineered for strength, flexibility, and endurance. There are three main species of rails in the steel family. The first is known as carbon steel rails. These are the marathon runners, tough, flexible, and perfect for long, straight, high-speed sections. They bend a little, but don't break easily, which is crucial when trains zoom past at 150 miles per hour. The second is known as low alloy steel rails. Now, these are the bodybuilders of the track world. They're strengthened with small amounts of alloying elements like vanadium or manganese, making them ideal for heavy freight trains that crush tons of weight daily. The last is known as heat-treated rails. They're the elite athletes. These undergo heat treatment to boost wear resistance and hardness, perfect for sharp turns or steep gradients where friction is brutal. So, when you're looking at a track, you're not just seeing steel. You're seeing a formula optimized for speed, weight, and terrain.
Now the fun part. Why on earth would railway engineers want rust on their shiny new tracks? To answer that, we need to study the villain, ordinary rust, first. When regular steel rusts, the surface turns into a flaky orange powder, the stuff you see eating through old fences and bicycles. It looks ugly, but more importantly, it causes structural weakness. Here's why. Such rust is porous and permeable. Ordinary rust is full of microscopic holes and cracks. These holes let oxygen and water keep slipping in, which means the rust never stops spreading. It's like building a raincoat out of a sponge. Normal rust is also flaky and non-adhesive. It doesn't bond tightly to the metal underneath. Instead, it peels off in thin layers, exposing fresh metal, which then rusts again. That's why regular rusted steel looks scabby. It's constantly shedding and reforming. Normal rust cannot self-heal. Once a spot rusts, there's no recovery. If you scratch the surface again, the corrosion restarts, over and over, until eventually the metal falls apart completely. So yeah, under normal circumstances, rust is the number one enemy of steel structures. But railway engineers found a way to hack rust itself. They designed special low alloy steels that want to rust, just enough to form a protective crust instead of a destructive one. Here's the chemistry magic. When these steels contain trace elements like copper, chromium, nickel, and phosphorus, their first contact with air and moisture triggers a controlled reaction. Instead of fluffy orange rust, the steel surface forms a dense microcrystalline oxide layer. Scientists call it patina, engineers call it active rust, and Mother Nature calls it camouflage. This patina is tightly bonded to the metal underneath. It's not flaky, it's compact and smooth. And here's the game changer. It's impermeable. Oxygen and moisture can't easily get through it, so corrosion slows down dramatically, sometimes stopping entirely after the first few weeks. And the best part? It's self-healing. If that protective layer is scratched or damaged, the exposed metal reacts again with air and water, generating a fresh new shield.
like skin regenerating after a cut. This is why engineers sometimes accelerate the process for new rails. They'll apply a mild chemical treatment or let the rails weather outdoors before installation so the protective layer is already formed. Such railway tracks are widely used in China, Japan, and Europe. So, the next time you see those reddish-brown rails, remember, that's not neglect. That's metallurgy with a PhD. It's rust reimagined as armor.
Okay, if the rust issue is so tricky, why not skip it altogether and just use stainless steel for the rails? Well, there are two big factors, cost and durability. Stainless steel costs around $2,000 per ton. Rail-grade manganese steel is around $400 to $600 per ton. That's a big difference. Now, multiply that across an entire national railway network spanning tens of thousands of kilometers, and your budget just melts faster than a chocolate bar on a summer rail track. Even more importantly, stainless steel isn't strong enough. Its yield strength, basically the stress point before it starts deforming, is only 200 to 300 megapascals. Rail-grade alloy steels like U75V, on the other hand, exceed 900 megapascals. That's nearly three times stronger. And while stainless steel relies on a thin, passive oxide film to resist corrosion, once that layer is scratched, and trust me, train wheels will scratch it, corrosion spreads quickly, especially in humid or industrial areas. So stainless steel is expensive, weaker, and ironically, less reliable in rough environments. Meanwhile, low alloy rail steel is tougher, cheaper, and, thanks to its active rust, self-protecting. So it suits railway tracks better than stainless steel. Now, just because the rails rust smartly doesn't mean they're left alone forever. Railway maintenance crews constantly monitor them with high-tech devices, such as ultrasonic and eddy current detectors, to scan for hidden cracks or flaws deep inside the steel. If any section shows too much corrosion or stress damage, it's replaced immediately. So yes, the rails are rusty on purpose, but they're also constantly supervised to keep the tracks safe.
So, that's the rusty truth behind those seemingly sketchy railway tracks. What looks like a maintenance mishap is actually a brilliant engineering wizardry to convert rust into smart shields. And with vigilant maintenance crews watching over, safety is never sidelined. Next time you're zooming along a high-speed rail or spotting those reddish tracks in a viral video, give them a mental high five. They're not just surviving, they're thriving, thanks to the clever rust hack. Who knew corrosion could be so cool? If this blew your mind or your misconceptions, smash that like button, subscribe for more fun deep dives, and drop a comment. What's the wildest engineering fact you've heard? Thanks for riding along. See you on the next track.